Welcome back to Fallout 1.5 Resurrection. I've got two things to do here in the Lost Town. One is to take out, I believe it's Rodriguez and Sanchez, to protect the ghouls that run the hotel. And the other is to find the hidden raiders that are being troublesome. Now, I was thinking that I couldn't find the raiders out here, and I was thinking maybe they're inside of the casino where Rodriguez and Sanchez are. But I took a quick look around before starting the recording, and I found a couple things that I definitely want to check out. For one, I can talk to this person over here. And second thing is, there's definitely some buildings back here that I haven't seen yet. So I'm going to look a little bit harder. What do you want here, huh? This is my place. If you want to collect, you have to go someplace else. Go. Go! What are you talking about? What? You're asking me what I'm talking about? You know too well what. Don't act like you don't know. Scram. Off with you. I really have no idea. Hmm? You're not a collector? What are you doing here, in my spot? Well, who are you? In fact, I don't really know. I've lost my memory. So you don't know if you're a collector or not? You don't, huh? Go away. My spot. Shoo! No, I'm sure of that. You're sure you're not a junk collector? You're sure? Absolutely. Wait, you, wouldn't you want to make some money? Caps, you want some? Sure. Travel, that's it. Easy, isn't it? Carry some stuff, useful stuff, huh? What stuff? Here, he shows you a pile of junk. Still useful. For Jonathan, he'll buy these. He'll give me 200 caps. It's all worth 400. Yeah, that much. So you earned something. I'll show you where to find him. So what do you say, huh? I feel like this is a really, really terrible scam, but you know what? Maybe. One man's junk is another man's treasure, right? Alright, give it here. Well, actually, before that, you want me to give you 200 bucks for junk? Good price. Very good. You'll earn 200 caps just for making the journey. That's good. And why don't you take the junk to Jonathan yourself? It's quite a stretch, and I gotta be here. There's lots of things here. Big, big money. Someone might pick them up before I do. I gotta collect. Alright. Show me the map. Yeah, show it. Here. He dabbed with his finger at a place on the map on your Pip-Boy. Jonathan, he lives in a scrapyard. Tell him it's from Charlie. He'll give you a good price. So go now. Hurry. Go. Okay, but if you've conned me and there's nothing there, I'll be back. And you're not gonna like that. Alright. So, it's actually off the map, isn't it? I think it's a totally separate location. Alright. Is it a formal quest? It is. Okay. You just give me the junk, right? Yeah. Oof. Weighs 12 pounds. How am I looking on weight? Where is it? Oh. No, it's here. Right? 96 out of 110, so I'm pretty close to the limit. I'll keep it on me for now, but I can give it to Carrie if I need to. Or some of the other junk to carry. Right, so let's look down here some more. After all, the quest does say to find the raiders that are hiding in the Lost Town. So if they're hiding, then it might be a little bit hard to find. So I'm going to make sure I extra talk to everybody. And look for any, I don't know, sewer grates or something like that they could be hiding under. Ooh, what's... I think I found him. I'm glad I didn't give up looking. Alright, let's save before I go down. Oh yeah. Raiders and more raiders. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is... Well, it's a... Assuming I don't die, it's a lot of XP and a lot of loot. Interesting graffiti. Sex, sex, sex. I'm gonna save the game again and just see if I can talk to them. I'm assuming they're gonna initiate combat right away. Oh. There's traps. Well, glad I saved. Where are they? Do they? I don't know how the trap system works in this game. Is there like a... There's a trap skill. What the heck does it do? I think you need to spot it first, though, and I haven't spotted it. Okay. Yeah. Well, that's a problem. Oh, now I spotted those. Why didn't I spot those? Well, it looks like you can maybe go around them. Maybe I should not run. Let's walk. Oh, fuck. Yeah, I just walked onto it. Alright, yeah. So it looks like for me it shows up when it's literally one step ahead of you, so you gotta be really careful. One step, one step. One step. Oh. Okay. Out of curiosity, what is using the trap skill on it do? Is it gonna simply fail or is it gonna blow up? Fail to disarm it, okay. Wait a minute. My companions are gonna blow them up, aren't they? I don't think they're gonna follow me. Exactly. Uh oh. Guess I didn't spot that one. You know, can I just like... Don't I have a grenade? I sold it, didn't I? Can I throw a flare? What the hell did that do? I guess you're supposed to use it when you're in a dark place? Hmm. I wonder if it's random or if running to a spot makes the next spot not show the trap. I think it's just random. Sometimes it shows it, sometimes it doesn't. Odd. Well, in that case, there's no reason to walk. So, there's one there. Ooh. Jesus Christ. Ah, thanks. Well, Kerry can take a bit of damage. The splash damage seems really low, it's only the direct damage that seems to make a big difference. Let's make a bunch of saves, I think I'm gonna need it. I'm probably gonna find that this place is too damn hard to take on anyway. Thanks. Okay. Alright, blow him up. Come on. Now you're about to blow him up. They'll do it later, I guess. Right, so let's just see if they shoot me right away before I can somehow talk to them or something. Okay, here we go. I see some nosy fuck got through our traps. I gotta take you to the boss. You won't make trouble, will you? Fine, I'll go with you. Hello there, babe. Oh god. I feel just douche chills just saying babe. Your pretty face could get hurt real bad here. What do you want? Alright, flex my speech skills. Which have been completely useless so far. If you're the leader of the Raiders, I've got a business proposition for you. Of course I'm a fucking leader here. The name's Damien. Now quickly tell me what the fuck do you want before I smash that pretty face of yours. We'll see if this works. Frederick, the owner of the Frederick's Dream Caravan Company, has found out about you. He sent me to kill all of you. For a small amount of caps, I could leave you alone and tell him you've been taken care of. And why the fuck should I do that? I'll kill you and keep the caps. Seems like the smarter option here. If you kill me, Frederick will send someone else, and there'll only be more of them. And then he'll send more and more men until he gets rid of you. But if I tell him you're no longer a problem, he won't be so afraid of the attacks, and his caravans won't be so heavily guarded. They'll be easy prey for you. Oh, but see, that's the thing. I do actually want to... Shit. That's the smart option, but I do actually want to protect them. Like, I don't want to actually help out the raiders. Huh. Alright, let's just see if I can take them on. Let's see how this goes. That was an automatic weapon. That is a very bad start. There's almost no way I can take them on. I'm not even gonna get the people in this room killed before there's like four more, but... Got a new weapon. With only I've only got 10 rounds in this weapon, that's right. Fuck me. Alright, whatever, let's try it. Okay. Well. Something. Yeah, this is not gonna work. There's absolutely no freaking way. They've all just used buff out, they're all buffed as hell. No. Okay, I guess I'll just make a deal for now and then hopefully come back later and kill them. Wait. What the hell? Where's the option? Where's the option? I have a proposition. The fuck? What the hell? I don't understand. Why did it disappear? Why? Really? Is there some sort of like, I don't know, save scum's cheat protection thing going on that stops you from doing something like that? I don't particularly think it's cheating. But that's the only thing I can think of. Why wouldn't that option show up? I didn't do anything differently, right? Huh. Okay. Well, hold on. Let me just run through. I'm gonna blow up a bunch of times. Fine, whatever. Okay, I died. That's not too good. Like, what if I just go to a slightly older save game and then run through? Even if I get super hurt, that's fine, whatever. Please don't blow up. Please don't blow up. God damn it. Alright, forget it. I give up. I can't do this yet. Go to an even earlier save game, though. I guess there isn't an earlier save game that isn't super far back because I overwrote it. Let me just try something. I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. That is so bizarre. I just loaded the save game slightly earlier from before I had gone through all the traps, and then made it through the traps again, and now the option's back. So weird. Okay, so let's do it. I'll make a deal with them, get some money from it, and then take them out when I'm more powerful. Okay, give you 500 caps if you do it. You're gonna get something from that asshole Frederick anyway. But if you tell somebody about our hideout, I'll rip your head off and shit down your neck. Is that clear? Sure. Actually, no. I want more. Oh. I don't negotiate, die. God damn it. Fucking. All right. I got a little cocky there, huh? All right. Let's try this again. Yes, yes, yes. 500 is fine. We have a deal. Thank you very much. Goodbye. Oh. Now I've got more money. Yes. More money. Good. Oh, Woofer, I think you're in my way. Excuse me. Thank you. So has the quest been updated at all? No, it still says eliminate them. So yeah, I guess I could go back to Frederick, but I'm not even going to go back to talk to him until I actually kill him, I think. Let's see if I missed anything else. Oh, yeah, Carrie got super banged up from hitting all the mines. She is almost dead. Well, you know what? Too bad. No, seriously though, I'm sorry, Carrie. I just don't want to wiggle around for like a month in the desert trying to heal you up. Nor do I want to spend the stimpaks. Alright, yeah, looks like that's it. Okay. Right. Let's see what's going on over here. This little fighting ring here. No match today, come back on the 4th. What match? Okay. Doesn't want to tell me. What is the... Nope, not combat. What's the date? Okay, the 4th isn't that far away. You know what? Let's actually just go do the scrapyard quest, and perhaps by the time I come back, it'll be the 4th. Hopefully the scrapyard isn't too far away. Yeah, not too bad. Uh-oh. You were hit for 20 hit points. Holy shit. I'm just so freaking squishy. Christ, and Carrie's almost dead. We gotta run. Ah, she just used her stim pack. Don't hit Woofer. You know, now that I've got distance on my side and a rifle, maybe I can take him. I mean, yeah, look at my accuracy now that I've got a rifle. 95 on everything. Whew! Carrie was hit for 29 and she didn't die? Now she's almost dead again. Hmm. I might die if they hit me. Do I have any stim packs? Or did I sell them all? I've got some. I guess I'll use both. They probably see. Well. That's game over. Not technically, but for me it is. I was gonna say, it probably seems like I'm wasting a lot of resources using stim packs for that encounter, but the stuff you get for killing people, like if people try to shoot you, well, they have guns. You kill them, you get their guns, and that is a shit ton of money. Like, that's really the main way of making money in all the Fallout 1 and 2, and I'm pretty sure in Fallout 1.5, is just killing people gives you so much equipment. Oh god. For a second I thought those were scorpions. Those are not scorpions. Those are those fucking mutated creepy damn things. I can't remember if they're hard or not. It is also nighttime, but I'm gonna try it. Ah, I missed. If I remember right, I didn't encounter these in Fallout 2 for a very long time until like the end game, so I'm feeling like they're probably gonna be, yeah, you know, I'm just getting the hell out of here. They're probably super hard. If I remember right, there were a million of these things at, like, the bottom of some sort of a ship in Fallout 2 that was in a dock. Oh, again? Pack of wild dogs, no thanks. Alright, we made it. Doggy friends! We found some friends, Woofer. Discovered a small site surrounded by car wrecks and all kinds of junk. Your arrival is accompanied by the barking of several dogs, which no doubt notified the owner of your presence. Yeah, we're gonna get back far after the fourth, so I guess we'll have to catch the next match. Are you Charlie? Or Jonathan, sorry. Hi, I'm Rena. Oh, so rude of me not to introduce myself. I'm Jonathan. You know how it is. I don't get many visits around here. Charlie sent me. I hope you know him. He said you'll pay me for the junk I brought from him. Okay, show me what you got. Junk, you say? Look at this. He takes out a rusty object. This might come mighty useful. And this, he jabs an unidentifiable part. That's what I call a nice catch. How much did Charlie say this is worth? Ooh, I could lie. Nah. I'm already making 200 caps. 400. Yep, that'll do. This catch is worth it. Here they are. Thanks. I think I definitely have enough money to go afford that rifle now. What do you know about Charlie? He seemed a little strange. I don't get to see Charlie often, but he's a good boy. A good boy? He looked like a 60-year-old man. He collects stuff for me, whatever he manages to, then sells it to me. I haven't seen him for a long time. I was getting worried, but it seems he ran into a good spot. I'm surprised there's someone willing to pay for garbage. Call it what you like, but these things are still useful. Everybody's living on the garbage of the past, but they're acting just like before the war. They throw stuff away, stuff that's still good for something. Wait, since you're here, could you help me with something? I'd pay you handsomely, of course. Handsomely? Are you a rich junk collector? What do you need? Some strange mutated creatures have been showing up lately. Sometimes when it's dark, they even attack. They never used to be around here before. In fact, I haven't seen anything like them until now. I think it has something to do with that guy living in a cave not far from here. He's never really bothered me before. Truth is, I've only ever seen him once, but he's the only person who might know more about this. I'm intrigued. What do you want me to do? I'll show you the map, mark the cave's location. You'd never find it without that. Find out as much as you can and try to get rid of those creatures for me if you can. I think I'll find something to pay you with. Sure. So many dogs. I love it. Can I do anything with this still? Let's science the still. Failed to learn anything. Well, I don't want to steal from this guy. I'm curious what's in here, though. Oh, it's locked. Alright, let's get out of here. Oh, it's super close. Asmodeus Cave. Asmodeus's Cave. You're standing in front of a cave. A fetid smell is emanating from inside. You can't help but notice piles of bones heaped around. You don't have a good feeling about this. Hmm. Oh. Wait, is that dead? Oh no, that's not dead. Jesus Christ, those things are so fucking disgusting. Ew, such a wet sound. Oh crap, I meant to walk further away, damn it. They got two moves? What the hell? Please die. Severely wounded. Yeah, they got quite a bit of health. I hope they don't do too much damage. Hmm. Oh, poisoned. It's okay, I've got an antidote. Come on. Still just severely wounded. You've received a large dose of radiation. Shit! That's not good. I don't have any rad meds. Fucking die! Almost dead, thank God. Please, kill it. Please? Carrie? No, 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 no. Carrie? I missed! Woofer? Please? I'm guessing there's more than just the one. Finally! Hope that's worth a lot of XP. 600 XP, nice. Mutt gained a level. Oh, Carrie's reached the next level. And I leveled up. Nice. Does it drop anything? No. Alright, let's take some antidote. And Christ, actually, maybe I should just use a first aid kit. I'm sure that heals more. I don't know if it gets rid of poisoning, though. Let's see. You heal one hit point. Are you fucking kidding me? What? Oh, wait. It doesn't disappear. What? I have no idea how first aid kits work. Can you just keep using it? Like, forever? Strain might kill you. Okay, so you can only use it so many times. You're too tired. Okay, so that's what the medical skill is for. Or the first aid skill. You kind of keep using it for a little bit. Once a day or something, I guess. That's cool. Right. Anecdote. Anecdote. Let me take this anecdote. Antidote. I'm still poisoned. Is that still poisoned? Okay, now it's all gone, but am I still irradiated? Perk time, get out of here. Wait. That didn't make it so I can't choose a perk, did it? Okay, thank God it didn't. Yep, I'm irradiated. And I've got no rad meds. I've Rad X, which protects me against radiation, but it doesn't get rid of it. Okay, it's fine. I'll deal with it. I'll go to a doctor or something. Let's see what kind of a perk I can get. Alright, so I'm gonna take the bonus move perk, which basically gives me 2 free AP points to spend only on movement. So I can't use it to shoot weapons or anything like that, but I can use 2 free AP points on movement. Which would be very nice for getting distance, especially since I'm more of a sniper character. That's super important. Alright, let's spend some more on... Man, I really want to get my lockpick up. Let's use a bunch on lockpick. Let's get that up to 50. A little bit more to... a little bit more to speech. Okay, that's good. I don't have to do anything for their level up, right? It just gives them better stats, I'm assuming. Right. Like, your HP used to be 80 or something, now it's 90. Yeah, okay, so their HP and stuff just goes up. Alright, if... Whoa, what? You saw me from all the way over there? Oh, God. Ooh, terminal. I could finally use my science skill. Okay. Oh yeah, so you can see this costs 0, this costs 0, then it starts costing actual AP points. So that's my bonus move working. Anyway, let's try to... I'm gonna try to power through. You know, now that I've got the advantage of distance, I'm not so freaking close to it. Maybe I'll be okay. Let's switch weapons, though. I think I have the wrong type of ammo in this thing. What's it? Hollow point? Oh, that's the right one, isn't it? Yeah, hollow point's the right one. Good against fleshy things. Alright, we're good. Oh, I can't even hit it from there. Yeah, Christ. Rifle's so much more accurate at range. I'll take some pot shots at it while it's coming towards me. Oh, God. Oh, fuck, that thing heard. Uh-oh. Not good. I'm hoping that thing's easy to take out. Get some distance while I've still got the time. As soon as that thing comes around the corner, I should probably start shooting it, huh? Not the greatest chance. I'm gonna go for the legs to try to slow it down. Get some more distance. Please defend me, friends. You're doing a very poor job right now. But I appreciate the effort. Please fall to the ground. Go as far away as possible without zoning out. Eh. I'm pretty low on HP now, alright. Christ, do I need to just kill this thing? I guess so. Shoot in the ganglion, that didn't even kill it. Fuck! Oh, man, these things are hard. It's only wounded, it's not even almost dead. Alright, you know what? You know what? I know what I need to do. I'm just ill-equipped for this. My equipment is just not good enough. I need something that can go full auto if I need it to. I need an assault rifle, which I can now afford. Okay, this assault rifle is damn expensive. But if I sell almost everything I have that I just don't necessarily need, the pistol, the tooth, this old key, I don't even remember what that was for, mentats, almost all my money, and most of my ammo for this kind of weapon that I don't use anymore, that I can buy the assault rifle, 100 rounds of hollow point, and 50 armor piercing. I'm hoping the assault rifle's pretty good. Because if it isn't, oh boy, there goes my life savings. But man, I feel like I really just need a better weapon. And something more dual purpose, right? Like, a sniper's nice from afar, but when a monster's all up in your face, then not so good. AK-1125mm assault rifle, an old military model out of use around the time of the war, can fire single shot or burst using high-velocity 5mm rounds. So I'm hoping I can use it kind of like a sniper, but if not, that's fine. I can always just switch to my hunting rifle. Okay. Does it come loaded? Yes. Comes with ammo. Sweet. Let's hope the thing does decent damage. And perhaps I can sell my Desert Eagle. But I'm not going to just yet. Let's see what kind of action points it needs. Single shot's 5, aimed single is 6, burst is 6. So there's no aimed burst, okay. Gotcha. Makes sense. Alright, let's go back to the cave, shall we? Okay, I've wiggled around to the point where I'm mostly healed. I also did get this message. You feel very nauseous, which I'm guessing is because of the radiation. I went to the doctor, and I couldn't seem to get rid of it at the doctor here. Not sure what's up with that, but, I guess I'm just gonna have to hope I find some anti-rad meds at the cave. Alright, try number 2. Whoops. I think I actually went to the world map just outside of the actual zone. This is just random desert. There we go. Alright. Let's test the accuracy from afar. 84%. Okay, compared to 95. Yeah, so let's just compare something that's not maxing out at 95%. The head, 64. Head, 44. So it's definitely less accurate than the actual hunting rifle, but, I mean, not terrible. But for now, I'm definitely going to use it until it gets closer. I think it's just, yeah, it's just knocked out, but hey, that's fine, I'll take it. Ah, damn it. Not unconscious, I guess. Come on, get this thing out of the way. I don't want to get poisoned again. That did shit for damage. How's it looking? Severely wounded. You know, I'm not going to take a risk. I'm just going to burst fire it. Damn it, I hit carry. I didn't even kill it. I did more damage to carry than I did to it. I want to get a better angle so the companions aren't in between it and me. Is it almost dead at least? It's just severely wounded. Christ. Still not dead? I just did 56 points of damage on it. Jesus Christ. Get it. Get it. Oh, it was killed. Good job. Alright. Please don't hit any of my companions. I don't think I did. No, I did. I hit Woofer for 32. Just come after me, please. Come on. Because I can outrun it. No, don't go for carry. I almost want to just not take my companions with me. And I'm just, like, they're, like, in the way constantly. Alright, that should be a oh, fuck. Yeah, I mean, this is doing a lot of damage, so I'm definitely happy with this purchase. These things are just really tough. Oh god, I hit all of them, but, okay, it's dead. Yeah, you gotta be really careful with burst. Jesus. So much XP! 1,250. That's beautiful. What's not beautiful is the fact that carry's almost dead, and Woofer's almost dead. So that's not good. I know, I know. Let's see, maybe those are the only ones. Let's see. Nope, there's definitely another one. Oh, and there's another one. It's so neat. So sci-fi horror. Well, none of them are gonna see me just yet, so... Let's see what I can do here. With science. It's locked. Oh god, I just opened them all. I just locked my companions inside. Whoops. Please come out. Thank you. No, no, woofer, no. Oh my god. Well, that's not too good. Oh, I hit the floater behind it. Yes, please attack me. And fuck, I've been a poison in one hit. Oh. 71 points of damage. Nice. I'm impressed. This gun is so good. Critically hit for 93. Such good XP. Okay, if you wouldn't mind coming out of there, woofer, please. Thank you. Now, I just need to close it before Woofer goes back inside, or the thing gets out. Whoops. Get it, Woofer. Get it. Get it. Run, Carrie. Run. Honestly, Woofer, you should be running too. Uh-oh. It heard. Okay, we need to run. We need to regroup and heal. Although I can't safely heal out here because I'll probably just get a random encounter if I wiggle around. Can I wait? Oh, I can wait here. Perfect. Wait until party is healed. Okay, thank god. I wonder how long this is gonna take. Oh man, whoa, 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 stop, stop, stop. Right, I'm taking damage from the poison. Alright. There we go. Also, I think I just took radiation damage, probably. Took more damage from poison? But there's no poison thing popping up. Yeah. It's odd. Okay, how you looking? Unhurt? Alright, Carrie. She's almost dead. Man, I wish my party passively healed a lot faster. Yeah, I'm hoping I can use my science skills in here, because it looks very science-y. It certainly looks like an experiment gone wrong, which is super cool. Okay, I'm out of patience. How you looking, Carrie? Severely wounded. You know what? Good enough. Oh, Christ. I've almost gone through all of my non-AP ammo. Okay, can't kill too many more of them without having to switch to my other gun, which is going to be way, way worse at taking them out. But hopefully there's not too many more. Let's look for supplies. Ooh. Remains a former member of the Children of the Cathedral. What are they doing in here? No, not the door. What is that? Is that a duffel bag or something? Nah, it's nothing, I guess. Iguana on a stick. Let's crack open a cold one. Ah, Nuka-Cola. See if we can snipe this thing from here. Oh, don't have the range. By the way, one of the modifications I can get at the gun store is for 2,000 caps, I can get a scope put on this hunting rifle. Oh, I'm out of ammo. Oh, right, I'm totally out of ammo. Shit. Well, in that case, Desert Eagle. What do you got? Hollow point. Good, good, good. Good for flesh. I'll take it. Uh-oh. That one maybe heard. Did it hear? Whew, I don't think it did. Let's run. Let's get it away. I don't want to fight two at one time. Please don't move. Please don't move. Good, it didn't. Yeah, why don't you come around the corner? Uh-oh. Got someone along for the ride. Shoot in the leg. Ooh, wow, nice. It's stunned. I'll just move over to the side so they hopefully don't get hit by the burst. Good, they didn't. 49. Severely wounded. Good. Ooh, not sure about that. Let's try this. Oh, thank God. Alright, we're good. Alright, I'm gonna take this thing out with my Desert Eagle. Save on ammo. Shoot in the foot. The single foot. The tail. Damn, it didn't trip. No, not Woofer. I don't know, shoot in the float sack. No, I hit Woofer! Why is my chance to hit so terrible? I'm pretty close to it. I guess I'll just go for the body. I'm doing terrible damage. Oh, Christ. Good. For a second, I thought she was dead. She's not dead, is she? No, she's just... No, not animal bones. Christ. Don't freak me out. She's not dead, right? I think she just critically collapsed or whatever. Okay, I think I need to step in. Please attack me. Don't go for Carrie. I'm right here. Come on. Yes. Not dead. Christ. Maybe I should just use burst against it. Is it almost dead? It's only severely wounded. Alright, fine. There. So, Carrie. Okay, yeah. So, yeah, she's fine. She's just taking a nap. Alright. Alright. I can't use a first aid on her, can I? Wait, what? She gained 10 hit points. I don't get it. Is she knocked out or what? I think it might be a bug. Well, let me take my last antidote, which isn't enough. Christ. I'm so yeah, she's fine. It was just a bug or something. Huh. Man, I am so fucked up, my character. And there's like nothing I can do about it right now. I'm radiated and poisoned. Okay. Well, I'm gonna wait for a while longer. Alright, I rested until the entire party is healed. And thankfully it looks like time actually heals your poisoned status, so that's gone. Still radiated though. But everybody's healed up. I've only got 10 more hollow point shots in my assault rifle. Which is not too good. So yeah, I wanna freaking loot this place. Those lockers look alluring. Wait, what's on? Oh, fuck. Alright, not even gonna shoot, just gonna run. Hopefully the other thing didn't see me. One thing at a time. Okay. We can do this. We can do this. I'm pretty sure it's probably just these two enemies, and I think that's it. Take a couple pot shots at it. Go for the eyes, try to get a crit or something. 43 points of damage. That's a lucky shot. Burst is my last resort. It's much less ammo efficient. Ooh! Well, only 9 points of damage. I'm just happy I hit, though. Shoot it in the groin. Yeah! Fell over. Nice. 47 points of damage. Getting some really good hits here. Ooh, it's actually, it's like passed out. Good. Just keep shooting in the eye. Oop, it's back. Do I have the ammo to even burst if I wanted to? I do. How's it looking? Almost dead, and crippled limbs. Alright, there's no reason to burst. There we go. How much ammo left? 4 shots. Alright, well there's really no point in using the AP. Yeah, so I'm not sure about this DR mod thing, but I did figure out that the damage mod basically means how much damage it does over the base damage, I guess. And the hollow point, I believe, does 2 times damage, basically, and the armor piercing does 1 times damage. So basically, it does half the base damage, the armor piercing, but it pierces through armor. But if you're shooting something like these monsters that doesn't really have armor, then the fact that it pierces through more armor is completely irrelevant, and the end result is that you do half damage. In other words, AP would be incredibly inefficient to use. It would do half the damage. So there's no point in really loading this in the gun. I might as well just switch to the Desert Eagle, I guess. Okay, there's two little ganglion monsters, but yeah, I'm pretty sure that's it. Let's take them out. Let's hope the other one didn't hear. Nope. Christ, you are really close. I could do a burst fire with only three rounds left. Huh. Heck, I guess I'm going to. Damn it, don't shoot, Carrie. I'm not really sure what I just loaded in. I guess it loaded in the AP. Either way, I'm not gonna use it anymore. Once again, my chance to hit is garbage. I wonder if it's the radiation perhaps hurting me. Oof. How's Carrie doing? Shit, she's almost dead. Carrie, run. Let me see if I can get closer. Here, attack me, please. Carrie? Carrie? Hmm? Carrie, run! Don't attack it, please! I think perhaps I should just leave him behind. Alright. Why don't you two just wait here? Is it a burst at this point? Wait, three hit points? Oh, I guess I only had one round left or something. Alright, whatever. Time to play. I don't know what you'd call this. Ring around the rosy, something? Take a shot, run away. Take a shot, run away. Hit points, nice. Super good crit there. Out of what? Oh, fuck, I must have ran out of AP. Crap, I think I'm using a hollow point. I think I'm gonna have to switch to AP for this too. Well, in that case, screw it. Let's burst fire it with AP. It's gonna be incredibly inefficient, but Let's do it. 29 points of damage. Just sad. I think I need to heal. If I can. Good, I can. Dear God. 8 points of damage. Woohoo! It's not even almost dead. I'm like so close to defeating this dungeon. 40 points of damage. Nice, nice, nice. Almost dead. Excellent, but I might die. Ugh. Oh, fuck! There's just like two little floaters left. Fuck me. I don't think I can loot those lockers before they come after me. Maybe there's something this way. I don't know, let's see what this does. What the hell did that do? Nothing, apparently. Alright, see if I can do something with this. Let's, science it. Fail to learn anything. Power plant, machinery. Blah, blah, blah. There's a terminal. Maybe we could do something with that. Alright, I'm just gonna see if I can loot this locker. Please have something good in it. Ooh, hello. Microfusion cell, small energy cell. This is for energy weapons. Okay, so I've upgraded my lockpick skill a little bit. Let's see if I can do this. With the help of my tools. Please. Oops. Ooh. Yes, I finally picked a lock for the first time in the entire game. Oh, feels good. Ooh, Rataway. Yes. This is great stuff. Great, great, great stuff. Okay, I am still radiated, yes? Yes, so let's use Rataway. Goodbye, radiation. Now I am still radiated. Okay. I don't need health. What else did I get? What was the other thing? Oh right, I got a second first aid kit. I don't know if two is any use at all. If you get tired and just can't use it anymore, is there any point in having two? Probably might as well sell one, I guess. Plasma grenade. Pulse grenade. Pulse grenade would definitely not be useful against non-electronic foes, but I don't know about plasma grenade. Magnetically sealed plasma delivery unit with detonating explosive creates a blast of superheated plasma on contact. I could try it, but I mean, these enemies just aren't worth it. Hmm. Hmm. They're not worth it. But I'm gonna try it anyway. Hell yeah! That didn't do very much. Also, my chance to hit was minus like 11%. Yet somehow I hit it? I'll take it. Please don't tell me I attracted the attention of both. I probably did. It was a freaking grenade. No, I didn't. Good. Okay. I shoot you in the ganglion until you're dead, you bastard. I got plenty of healing items. Stab it good, Carrie. Right, so before I reload it with something that's probably just going to be garbage. Yeah, so I think what happens while I keep running out of ammo fast is because it reloads it with this, which is only two shots, and then goes to this. So let's just go to this, I guess. It's armor piercing, though. What's the point? There's no point. I might as well just load this with armor piercing. Don't want friendly fire. This should be safe. Still wasn't safe. Did more damage to carry. Carry. You're almost dead, aren't you, Carrie? She's almost dead. Well, at least I can... Wow, I could just push her away in combat. That's cool. That's really cool. Please attack me. Please attack me. Let me get in the way of it and carry. No! Is she dead? What happened? No, she's not dead. Good. Good, good, good. Now she's actually running. Good, except she's running in the direction of another freaking floater. Oh, I'm out of ammo. It's still not dead! It feels invincible! Carrie, please. Carrie, please. It's right there, I'm pretty sure. It's still- what the fucking hell? Carrie, don't go into the cage, don't run into the cage, don't run into the cage. Okay, she didn't run into the cage. Good. Good, good, good. Don't accidentally friendly fire her. Oh my god. Why is this so hard? It's all because of the ammo. If I just didn't have armor piercing and had enough ammo for these two last little fuckers, this would be easy. This is torture. I just want to see what's in the room. I just want to mess around with the computers. It's not too much to ask, is it? I guess I could have healed Carrie. I don't know. I almost want to just run back to... Oh. Hello. I almost want to just run back to town and sell some of my stuff and buy more ammo. I'm gonna do it. Alright, let's try this again. I went all the way back to set it to the gun store and I sold basically everything that I found in those lockers. All those like energy ammo and pulse grenades and such things. Which all in all was worth around 2,000 or so. And I used it to buy 250 rounds of holopoint for this and then 200 rounds of armor piercing. So I've got plenty of ammo. And for some reason, when I came back in here, there was a ganglion thing here. Oh, right, it's because it chased me out. That's why it's here. Alright, this should go a lot better. That was terrible, but still, it'll be fine. With the right ammo, shouldn't take too many bursts. 48, beautiful, beautiful. Please don't shoot Carrie. At least I did more damage to it than to Carrie. Is she almost dead now? Nah, she's just severely wounded. She's fine. How about you just move out of the way, Carrie? Just a little bit. Oh, okay, sure. Just a little push. Nope, not a little push, no push. Okay. Carrie was right there. You could have just shot over her shoulder. I mean, let's be real here. Christ, she's gonna die again. Oh my god, Woofer killed it. Good job, Woofer. I'm so proud of you. Now, how about you both stay here? Alright, one out of two down. Just one more. Just one more, right? Yeah, it was the one from the cage that followed us, I guess? Okay. Nice little ricochet sound. Come on. Almost feels like I've got the wrong ammo loaded, but I'm pretty certain I don't. Dear God. I'm gonna heal. I think Woofer's coming to help me or something. This is a joke, right? Can't heal. Uh-oh. It might actually kill me here. Oh my god! How are these things, like, harder than the big monsters? Like, seriously, what's going on here? Do I have the wrong ammo loaded? No, jacket to hollow point. It's hollow point. Come on. Eleven points of damage for that entire burst. Like, maybe these things are armored or something. Because to the other things, I kept doing like 50 damage, you know? Could it be? Could they be armored? They don't look armored. I'm gonna try it. No, I've already tried that against him when I was desperate. Yeah, I already tried that. Alright. There's no point. It's all loaded up. They actually are seriously harder than the bigger things. It's only severely wounded. It doesn't even seem like there's a point to burst firing. I might as well just try to shoot it in the eye, right? Or it doesn't have an eye. You know what I mean. Screw it. I'll use it all. Yeah, that did some serious damage. Good. Fucking hell. I don't have anything left to heal with. I'm just gonna burst it. Hope it dies. It's not dead! What the fuck? This is a joke, right? Okay, well, I guess I'm gonna eat an iguana on a stick. How much did that heal me? Did it even heal me? I said nothing happens. Great. That was worthwhile. Cool. Now I'm super dead. This is so weird. I didn't expect to get through all of that so easily, and then suddenly I'm stuck on this. Alright, well, nothing to do but keep trying, I guess. I'm gonna stop burst firing and just go for its ganglion. Was it for 3 hit points in the ganglion, and that's garbage. Maybe that's not the best place to hit it. Alright. The mouth? Doesn't even seem to matter. This guy really better pay me handsomely. I just always assume the hardest thing to hit is the thing that where it does the most damage, so I guess I'll keep going there. How's it looking? Just wounded. Try to trip it. A 1 in 20 chance I would miss, and I missed. That's doing even worse damage than everything else. That made a metal pinging sound. There's nothing metal around me. Oh my god, I think I'm gonna die again. How's it looking? Just wounded! This thing has like 200 hit points or something. I'm so sad. Does this stay wounded? I've got to test something. Does this stay wounded? It does stay wounded. Okay, that's good. That means I can go out and heal. Thank God. Jesus Christ. This is so bizarre. This is like the boss nasty ganglion thing. How did the others die so easily? I don't understand. I feel like I'm really missing something. Alright, that's enough. Yeah, it really isn't doing more damage than just doing single fire, for the most part. Time to go heal again!
Oh man, I feel so pathetic. This is really the only thing I can do, though. I'm so determined to finish this. I hope my reward is worth it. That's the big thing keeping me going, is hopefully he gives me like some amazing piece of junk that he found that's actually incredibly good. Oh, thank God. Managed to start the encounter myself. Hey, a crit! Finally, severely wounded. All right, we're going places. Oof, it got a good crit too. I think I've got a heal again. Yeah, it seems to have like crazy good sequencing, to the point where the first time you encounter it gets to go twice. I wish I could think of more to say to make all this waiting entertaining, but not much to say. This is one of the bad things about Fallout 1 and 2, and the turn-basedness and all that, is it's prone to moments of slowness like this. But I still love it for some reason. Just bashing my head against this for some reason is actually kind of fun. Like, I'm so damn determined, and it's gonna feel so good when I finally get this. Another crit? Nice. It's gotta be almost dead at this point. Yep, almost dead and crippled limbs. Still not dead somehow. It's so close. I'm pretty sure one more half-decent hit and it's down. You know, I do. Th isn't there. I'm trying to remember. Is there one more Ganglion thing left in one of the cages? I might have to kill it to get the reward because he wanted me to kill all of the monsters. But I might have accidentally killed it too because I accidentally let it out of the cage. I'm not sure if I loaded a save over that or not. Okay, I got the drop on it. Come on! Yeah! Oh, no, it's not dead yet. Okay, this is the one. This is like taking out a Dark Souls boss. You've cleaned the cave of all mutated creatures that could threaten nearby locations. Thank God! Oh my God, that feels amazing. That was so hard, and I leveled up. Oh, that feels amazing too. Hell yes. That was hard, but that was, I think, worth it. Even if I don't get a good reward, whatever. It feels good. All right, let's get lockpick up 10 more points. Let's get that up to like 100%. 102? Yeah. Let's get that up to 102 and that up to 82. There we go. Decent lockpick skill. And then kind of maxed out speech. Well, I mean, 100% isn't maxed out, but it feels good to get to 100%. Alright, let's explore this place properly. Let's open up the cages. Is there anything inside the cages? No monsters, obviously, but I mean, stuff to loot. It's hard to see. I don't think so. Really want to use some of these computers. Science it. Nope. Holodisc, yes. And some robes, which I could possibly use to. I think you use robes in Fallout 2 to sneak into the Children of the Cathedral or something like that. So this might be able to be used for a similar thing. Compose as one of them. Take a look at that holotape. Traces of blood on it. Downloading disk data. Where does it go? Ah, Journal of Asmodeus. Let's see. Okay, cool. I, Asmodeus the Great, decided to write this journal so that future generations will know how I established my reign. It was not easy. It took lots of sacrifice. But now I can feel that success is in the air. Years of disregard and mockery from Morpheus and the others is finally over. From now on, I shall be the one to laugh. Next entry. Soldiers of the Unity deserted and spread after Master's death. Supermutants fled far to the east. Floaters and centaurs remained and learned the ways of survival. Their anatomy did not change, however. There is still a part of their brain sensible to the mind of humans. Alas, this telecortex only responds to the Master's mind. I'm certain, however, that it can be adapted to any human's mind using a process called neural reorganization. Once I succeed, I shall have thousands of absolutely loyal soldiers. With the Unity resurrected, I can conquer the entire world! Okay, so they're trying to control the centaurs and other and floaters with their mind. Next entry. Be damned, world. One of the centaurs died today, suddenly, without warning. During post-mortem, I discovered that forced evolutionary virus used as primary neurotransformer mutated heavily since last tests and ceased to serve its original purpose. I must redo the virus transmutation procedure, regardless of the delay. The autopsy, however, indicated that I am on the right track. The neural organizer worked the way it was supposed to in the beginning, altering the telecortex structure properly. After a couple of minutes, the FEV became unstable, attacking the somatic tissue, which unfortunately led to exodus. Obviously, the mutation must be regulated somehow, as it is currently too excessive. Next, experimenting with neural reorganization using an altered FEV batch 13-024 yields positive results with both floaters and centaurs. The modern plague virus proved to be a good mutation regulator. Oh god, they're using the plague? Jesus Christ. Good fortune smiles on me. Proof that I was always meant to rule this world. Floaters seem to be more exploitable than centaurs, probably because they have fewer heads. Three young floaters are being altered from infancy. They're showing great progress. My hopes lie with them. They shall become my very first soldiers. Next entry. I can feel my ultimate goal is at hand. Sometimes I speculate, why was I predestined to be the next great leader of the world? I understand now where the Master erred. He held down too much, not using all the available resources. Blinded by his utopic visions of harmony, he failed to see that the proper way to establish power only lays through massive violence. He refused to use it sufficiently. The entire Unity was smothered in his utopic dreams. It was always meant to fall. The Master held back. I shall not repeat his mistakes. More and more, I become aware of how misled he and his entire organization were. Perhaps I should have disposed of my robe, my only connection with Children of the Cathedral, but I become accustomed to it over the years. Besides, it seems to have a calming effect on floaters and centaurs. That could, however, imply that their knowledge comes from genetic memory. Ooh. Seems to have a calming effect on floaters and centaurs. Just to the ones that he had here, or just to all of them? If so, then that could be extremely valuable. Nonsense. I should keep myself away from such foolish thoughts. I still have a lot to accomplish. It is time to embrace my fate. Next entry. And last. Today I performed the last set of tests on three young floaters. Subject 1 shows the most positive reaction to the transmutation agent. I think it's ready for the final phase. It shall be treated with the final dose of the neurotransmutation virus today. Then it shall prove its allegiance to me. It shall lead its brethren and bring nearest city to oblivion. The new dawn of humanity shall end before it even started. People shall submit to my tremendous power, or die. Science experiments gone very, very, very wrong. Do any of these do anything. They really don't seem to do anything. I don't think there's any point on just using science on every random computer. I think they would have a special description indicating it did something. Just for good luck, I'll use science randomly on this computer. Nope. There's nothing more I can loot, is there? Oh, wait, there's a table. Oh. No stuff in the stuff. Dang it. Okay, that really is it. Man, I'm just itching to use my science skill. Alright, friends, let's go. Where's Carrie? Carrie? Maybe they'll appear outside. Carrie? Where the fuck is Carrie? Shouldn't she be like right here? Please don't tell me she, like, died or something and I didn't notice. Carrie? What the hell? Where's Carrie? Why can't I find Carrie? I mean, if she's just gone, then honestly, I might just say fuck it. Like, she wasn't that helpful in combat at all. She was only good as a pack rat, and she keeps dying. I would never give up Woofer, but Carrie, eh? Am I blind? Is she just, like, right in front of me, and I just don't see her? I'm just gonna leave. I mean, if you forget where a companion is, I don't know what happens. Do they go back to their original position, or do they just stay there forever? I don't know, maybe she'll be here when I fast travel. Or, well, it's not really fast traveling, but, you know, going on the overworld map, perhaps. They spawn back with you? Nope, they don't. Maybe she died, Jesus. I don't know. Oh, anyway, okay. They were really coming from that man's cave. His name was Asmodeus, and he used to be a child of the cathedral. He was taking care of those creatures and doing some experiments on them, but they killed him. Well, what do you know? So they got themselves a nest there. I hope you dealt with him. Mm-hmm. Good job. I have a nice pile of caps put aside. They're of no use to me, so I might as well give them to you. 2,000 caps. And here, take this as well. He hands you a strange thing. It's an electronic part. Looks quite important. I'm sure you'll be able to use it somewhere. Believe me, I can tell. I've got no use for it. Where'd you get so much money, if you don't mind me asking? I know a few people, mostly from caravans. They stop by now and then when they need something fixed. Of course, they pay me for it. Doesn't happen very often, but I got nothing to spend that money on. I got all I need, so they just pile up. Okay, thanks. So what did you give me? Electronic part. Most likely this is a specialized part for a specific machine. Judging from the part itself, it is virtually impossible to determine what machine it's from or what its function is. Fascinating. I wonder what the heck I'm gonna use that for. I mean, I wonder if that's some sort of a side questy thing. Like, is this like a car part that you needed to build the car in? Was it Fallout 1, I think, you had to, like, repair a car? Well, I don't think you had to, but you could. I wonder if it's similar to that, where it's like a thing you don't need, but it's pretty cool? Or if it's actually part of a main story kind of mission that you need, and you need it to complete the game. I don't know, but I'm fascinated. Okay, well, holy shit, this has been a long episode. I think it's a pretty good place to end this episode. I feel very accomplished. I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm trying to think if I'm powerful enough to go take on the raiders. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm not gonna take on the raiders immediately. I'm gonna go back to town, I'm gonna buy some armor, and then I'm gonna take on the raiders.